Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior, welcome back to DK64. I just want to take care of a few loose ends in Foggy Forest. I'll go back to Crystal Caves in this part. Here in the lobby, you can see there's this mushroom here, and I talked about how I'm supposed to do something about it, and well, now I have the means. So that's the first thing. Second thing. Switches again. Get Lanky out. Da 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 da. Chunky. And finally, Tiny. What this does is it opens up a Chunky pad. This is why I said you couldn't do anything about it before, but now that we visited Crystal Caves and got abilities, now it's absolutely no problem. And what Gorilla Gone does is it almost switches, it's almost like Chunky switches dimensions or something, because when he disappears, things that are invisible suddenly appear. Albeit temporarily. So here we go. Forest Fracas. Relatively simple. You do have Chris Platts, though. And then you have Kremlings and Bones, which basically are the same thing. They both can take a shot and keep coming. I actually sparred him off the edge. I'm happy. That takes care of that. So anyway, I did mention there's one banana I couldn't get here at Foggy Forest. I probably mentioned it ad nauseum at this point. So I will meet you there. First, let's wake this rabbit up. Very simple, but the rabbit will give you a pretty hard time. He's not gonna pull any punches. So you're gonna have to work to get past him. Just straight up, just try to cut the corners as much as you can, but don't cheat, because you have to hit every single gate. Oh yeah, and he does like showing off. Because who doesn't like showing off? The seal showed off a bunch too. Oh yeah, and watch for the enemies. They are not your friends here. Oddly enough, I think the rabbit can destroy the crystal bat. I think I've seen it. And it's hilarious when it does happen. But the crystal bat is probably your number one threat. And obviously the zingers aren't too nice either. See? I told you, the rabbit's charging destroys things. And since I took the turn extremely hard, I imagine you have a chance. But the rabbit has good speed, so I'm not out of the woods yet. And winner, winner, chicken dinner. Give me my banana. Oh yeah, and then he says he's half-assing it while he's crying over it. Astounding logic, I know. Consolation prize. They don't deal in consolation prizes. I'm just 40 warrior. I go for it all. Get your ass up, we're doing this again. Now actually, he wasn't kidding. He was half-assing it. Hence why now you have a character barrel right there. And I want to take this seamlessly. And this is the one challenge where you don't have infinite crystal coconuts, so you really want to make sure you have enough. You want to make sure that damn zinger doesn't get to you. And the rabbit is fast! Ooh, lordy, is the rabbit fast. He's whooping me. This is not easy. You would think having a rank spray was supposed to just make it super easy. You'd be wrong. This guy's gonna whoop me. And he's a rave whooping me. Well, he'd be badly. Yeah, this is gonna be tough. I do remember this race taking me a while. It's not one of those races, you know, you think you can just skate by. Hung up there is not gonna help. Oh, what? I could have sworn he could destroy the curse blot. Instead, the curse blot just helped me. Holy shit. Oh, I better win this. I'm not gonna get a gift like that again. And do I feel bad if I take advantage of this? Abso-freaking-lutely not. There's no way I'm gonna feel guilty over this. Wow, I just got an assist from the cursed plat.
No. No.
So I win the golden banana with an assist from a cursed plat. That happened. Wow, that happened. That's awesome. Makes you wonder how the rabbit can completely truck a clump and not a kersplat. Anyway, I'm gonna go back to DKL's because there's one other thing I can do here.
Okay.
Man, I'm psyched. I expect it to take me like 3 or 4 tries, not 2. Unfortunately for me, Lanky has another challenge that that consists of a very tough race. And let's just say I am not looking forward to that. Not one bit. Oh yeah, I forgot. There's also that one, too. So yeah, I gotta bring Lanky back to Calumsy's cage. But over here, I didn't really explore this at all. There's only one thing of note over here, and it's a tiny pad. What K-Roll is doing with any clone pads is beyond me. But once I kill this fairy. Please do not misconstrue those words. That was not meant to be anything innuendo-oriented. Okay, now I got that out of the way. this is here. And memory serves me right, this does double duty. Gives you a banana, but he also mentions he saw a special barrel. So, yeah. This sets the stage for another golden banana. So in reality, I can get two more golden bananas. Which, well, I have no complaints over. And that's the can to go to the other thing if you will so desire. I don't at this point. I'll take care of that when I take care of that, which will be after I take care of this coming level. First, I need to get Lanky. And then I got to use Chunky for a little bit. So in here I did mention in passing a switch. The switch still exists. But what I didn't tell you was about the Lanky barrel that was sitting right there. Oh. Okay. Well, that's kind of a glitch, but whatever. As long as it doesn't break the game, I don't care. Oh yeah, now Squawks tells me, even though I was clearly just running in a race before that. Then again, I'm glad he wasn't interrupting me during said race. Now a banana opens, and you don't have much time to get it. Like I said, not much time at all. Not sure. I'm guessing Kirill decided to leave the banana there just to rub it in, but that was kind of dumb. Of course, he probably didn't expect a Kong to know how to run on his hands, which clearly happened. Okay. Now for Chunky. Now, the Chunky barrel is actually over here in this island where I found that one banana fairy. And the premise is to take care of that thing that looks like a helipad, but there's no helipads in Donkey Kong. In DK's world, so the next best thing, take a giant Chunky and do that. Hey, you know what? I feel like just crossing large sections of the map, so I'm just gonna stay big for a little bit. Crystal coconuts be damned. Also, I get a very good chance to see Chucky's heart, evidently. Anyway. So yeah, that happened. And that took me a little longer than I expected. I thought this was going to be like a 10-minute affair. So... I can take care of some stuff at Crystal Caves, but not much. So... I'll meet you back at the Crystal Caves lobby, just before I head in. Okay. There was actually a golden banana for Chunky almost literally immediately as soon as you enter the stage, but I couldn't do anything about it until I took care of, shall we say, other business. Namely the Stalactite thing, because, well, I just can't stand it. Anyway. Over here. Oh, there's a DK, balloon, too. You have this. And that. Yeah, very little time to get everything, but well, once you do, you don't have to worry. And now I get to go back to listening to this music. And just feeling good about myself. Because this music is nice, and relatively speaking, serene. More befitting of a cave rather than the stupid cave-in music. I may be guilty of humming this a few times. I'm just gonna lay that out there right now. I'm almost doing it right now, actually. Okay, so he's got some stuff right here. Good to know. Oh, that should be headphones right there, yep. Okay. Well, I'll oblige. I already got 55 bananas with Chunky. Damn. Okay, now to do something serious. One of the things that was around Cranky's lab was actually a Diddy barrel, but I didn't do anything about it. This is why I didn't feel like using the jetpacks when there's a freaking cave-in. So. So there's two things I really want to take care of before I actually call this apart. This Diddy's thing being one of them. Also, I now have 30 yards just because I saved enough fairies. But Diddy, you want to go down here and you want to cross this DK star. But Diddy has other uses. Well, for one thing, there's a lot of bananas to collect. But one thing about Crystal Caves that I'm not as big a fan of is there are a couple of banana pads that only he can get to. And how can you get to them? Oh, with the jet barrels. So, provided I don't waste my entire crystal coconut supply. I'm just gonna take care of that really quick. It can be a pain in the ass to get these too, because literally, well, there's banana port 4 right there, as you can see. It is not a nice one to get. Yeah, you gotta be pretty precise to get that one. And you'll see why I clipped banana part 4 in a little bit. Anyway, that's not the entire crystal caves, because it almost seems like it is at this point. So, that being said, there's other parts you gotta explore. And well, for that, we're gonna use Tiny because there was a lot of tiny bananas underwater. And I mean a lot. Oh yeah, right here I believe is Banana Port 5. Once again, only Diddy. Through here, this is the other part of Crystal Caves that I really didn't get to yet. As you see, there's a candy shop right here. I keep calling it a candy shop, it's candy shop, come on. And this, third melon and 20 charges. Not like you really need more charges, but hey. Always a fan of the third melon. And especially for one of these challenges, you're going to want 3 melons. I know, because I've clearly been in danger of dying from HP reduction at no points during this LP, but there will be a point where, yeah, that goes out the window. Here's Banana Port 2. So, definitely want that, because now I can actually get around places. Oh, and an added bonus. Okay, dumbass, you're... That's a good place to stop it. Next time, well, I get to get bananas for once. And I can actually take the pursuit a lot more seriously. See you guys then, 40 Warriors signing off.